Welcome to GTA Online. I am your captain today and I want to talk to you guys about some of the basics of the game. Not even how to make money or what to buy for it, but instead the real basics. How to set up a session, how to invite your friends, how to manage multiple menus like the phone, like the social club overlay and the interaction menu. Last of which is actually something that when I started out playing, I didn't know it existed for weeks, and especially now it's really useful and you should know how to navigate it. So this is what this video is about, just getting you some of the basics and especially how to get into a session that doesn't involve any griefers and actually also cuts down on loading time. If you already know quite a few things, this still may be new, at least if you look at how many people are just playing in public sessions and getting their ass handed to by a griefer on a flying rocket bike of doom. So, first things first, I want to go in a slightly chronological order. So, the first thing you do when you start up trying to play GTA Online, you will get into a character creator and you will also be able to set your stats. This is something that's more optional than anything else, but I wanted to quickly give you guys my idea of a slight optimization in stats in order to mess them out quicker. You would think that it's really important to have like good stats in shooting and driving from the get-go, because in the end that's what most of this game is about. But since this is the main focus of the game, it's also the things that you are leveling up the quickest. So I usually tend to just reduce the shooting stat to minimum, the same for flying and driving, because those are things that level up incredibly quickly in this game. And I just like to put the stuff into maxing out first up strength, then stealth, lung capacity, and last but not least stamina if you have anything left, because especially the strength stat takes ages to level up. Because of that you actually need to punch other people, and that quite often and repeatedly, so that's gonna take a while to level up, and therefore just having a bit more of a head start in that is usually not the worst idea. Ultimately the stats don't matter all that much, so if you have a character already, you can just keep them anything. There's no reason to just sacrifice the character and any progress that you made already in order to get this optimization going. It's really more of an optional thing than anything else, but I wanted to just quickly mention it. So now to the most important thing about the sessions. Once you start GTA Online, you will end up in a free public session, and it's kind of a shit show usually. It takes forever to load in because the game, since it's peer-to-peer, needs to connect you to everybody else in the lobby. Which, with 20 other people, some of which likely will have potato internet, it will take its time. Sometimes you will even just time out before you can get into a session like that. But there is a way to get around everything, including all the assholes on flying bikes. And that is by just going into the pause menu by pressing start or the escape button. Leaving GTA Online or going into the creator. Creator is ultimately a bit quicker, I think, but it doesn't really matter all that much. Because the game from single player actually allows you to set up different kinds of sessions where you can actually control who will be in a session with you, and you could just also play on your own if you so desire, so that will definitely reduce the loading times, not only loading from single player to GTA Online, but also once you are in a lobby for making like doing a race, a deathmatch, some kind of contact mission, whatever. Once you get back into the free roam lobby, this will also have the same kind of impact on the loading time. So, we are in single player right now. What we want to do is just press the start button again, get into the pause menu. Quickly before we get into the sessions, there's also the targeting mode thing, which is more important for people doing playing on controller. The thing is, targeting mode, you can only have one targeting mode per session, so everybody needs to have the same one in there. If you're joining somebody else's session and they have a different targeting mode, they will, your targeting mode will be adjusted to theirs. Can be quite annoying, especially if you have friends that are using a different type of targeting mode, and if you want to change it again, you actually need to go back into single player or the creator in order to do this kind of stuff. And yeah, in the creator main menu, You can also just press the pause button. Works the same way as here. And if you're booting up the game, don't go into GT Online. Go into single player first and then go into this menu, the online tab, play GT Online. And instead of going on go, which is again public session, these sessions down here are what you are looking for. Invite only session, you are going into a session on your own, but you can invite anybody from your friends list in order to join you, and yeah, will just be all the people that you invited. They can also invite people, so you can fill a full lobby with people that you know and that you know will not mess with you too much, outside of maybe a friendly manner, hopefully. But yeah, apart from that, you can also go into a multi-crew session, which I don't really use that often. You can set how many crews you want in there, and once you have that amount of different crews, yeah, then that's that. There's also the option to go into a closed crew session, which is a bit more popular. Basically, you can have five crews, or you can join five crews in GTA Online, and you can always have one crew active, and I think you need to be active in that crew in order to join a session like this. But yeah, if you just want to have certain crew members in there, this is how this works. And I think you would just go into the crew session right away, and it would be that crew that you have active right now. Close friends session is pretty much the same as close crew session, but for people on your friends list. And yeah, everybody who wants to join the friends list, they can just join you, just like that. But they need to be on your friends list. There's no option for friends of friends to join. It's just the people that are on the friends list of a person who hosted the session. They can join in, everybody else needs to stay out or send them a friend request. But since some of the invite-only sessions and all that, they sometimes split up after doing a few jobs or so and going back into free roam, having a session where your friends can just join on your own without you needing to send out invites and all that might be the better solution there. Solo session doesn't allow you to join anybody else, it's just you on your own, and that's about it, so that's kind of a boring thing. I would definitely suggest invite only session over that, some of the close crew or friend session, depending on what you exactly want to do, might be more up your alley, but ultimately choose one of those settings and it will get you back into online real quick. Sometimes when you boot up the game and go single player first, went into online, it may take a bit longer, but ultimately I'm not cutting anything here, this is how quick it usually goes. If you have multiple people in the session, it will get a bit longer, but certainly not to the extent of what you can expect when joining a full public free roam lobby. And yeah, that's the loading times already, and I think that's the most important tip that there can be. Because this now got rid of anybody who would want to mess with me and also just made the loading so quickly. And yeah, if there's any takeaway from this video, use invite sessions or anything else that isn't fully public. So besides that, we also have some other stuff to go through. For example, the actual online options. There isn't much to talk about here, and I will keep this stuff short and only to the most important points. Map, not too much to talk about here, should be all self-explanatory. You can set your waypoint or even some little other things right here that don't get any marker on where to go. But yeah, that stuff is this. I will talk a bit about how to get rid of some of the stuff displayed on the map in a bit, that's actually in another menu. Apart from that, there are some online options down here. You could theoretically purchase shark cards or Criminal Enterprise Starter Pack, but that's something that I would highly suggest you don't do, because it's absolutely useless. You can easily get the progress you would get from this kind of stuff by just playing and investing wisely, but we'll get to that likely in another video. So the options here, enable passive mode, also works through the interaction menu. That doesn't allow you to aim with any weapons or so. It can only be used in regular vehicles without weaponry, and as long as you are not a CEO or something. It's kind of a boring thing to do, because even if you steal an NPC's cars and they drag you out, start punching you, you can't even punch back, so I wouldn't suggest that. Quick play action is something that you can set here. I would say go for eat snack, because that allows you to get health back. You can get snacks through grocery stores on the map and gas stations. Basically all the symbols where you can rob a store are also where you can buy the stuff. Likely before robbing it afterwards. other things that are rather important, matchmaking I would say. I like to keep this to close, because otherwise if I host up a job, the game would automatically send out invites to my friends and all, but if I just wanted to test out something on my own or do a quick mission on my own, then yeah, bothering them with invites isn't all that great, and it's rather quick to just open matchmaking manually and also just get the people in that you want to have in your job. So I would set that to close. It's usually set to open by default. Betting odds and all that. I think that's the most important stuff already. The rest isn't really all that important. You can figure things out on your own there. Crew options, as I said, you have the options to join 5 crews in total. Here's where you can take a look at them. Also take a look at the members of the crew, which are online or not online right now. And you can also set to another crew as active if you need to, but then it will just kick you out of your current session. Also, a lot of this stuff can be handled through the Rockstar Social Club website on the real-life internet. And that will actually have quite a few options there that you may want to take a look at. And yeah, it's a whole separate thing, it's not all in-game. But things like the crew stuff can also be managed through there. And besides that, there's also one other little thing here, and that is the players menu. Here you can actually take a look at all the players in your session, and if somebody, for example, wants to initiate a vote kick on somebody, this is the menu where you would do that. You just scroll down to the person's name, and there will be a button for vote kick and other stuff, so that can be quite handy as well. Other than that, playlist options. If you want to create a playlist, you can bookmark stuff on the Rockstar Social Club website, or after playing a job or something like that, and just create your own playlist or bookmark other people's playlists and all that kind of stuff. So this is where you can find that. Joining friends and crew members is a bit random, because it just brings a random guy apparently and just puts you into their session if it's open to you. With jobs, you can take a look at jobs that you played and jobs that you want to play. There is a lot here. You can take a look at your own jobs, jobs that you bookmarked, jobs that you recently played, and jobs created or verified by Rockstar. And the lists are quite extensive, so no reason to go through that. Just know if you're looking for something specific and you know how to find it, you can find it in here, if you really want that one specific thing. But yeah, so much about this. There's also the friends menu, where you can just go on to inviting other friends to your stuff and also joining them. This is not what I would recommend to go through, because it's always a bit iffy if the stuff actually comes through. So for managing your friends and inviting people, I would suggest you go to the actual social club overlay right here. The thing is how to open that. If you press the pause button, you will get a button prompt right here that you can take a look at. Otherwise, it's also in the settings. Depending on your keyboard layout and your platform, it may be different, so I can't really tell you any button, because it might be a completely different one for you. But this is generally how to find that button. And if you are on a console, this might also be different for you. You might just go through the Xbox app Xbox overlay, whatever, PlayStation overlay. They have their own systems, and on PC it's definitely this one that you may want to take a look at, because this one is the most reliable one. On the homepage, you already get your friends sorted first up by online and then also alphabetical. So this guy I could invite to my game, I could join their game, and yeah, this is the easiest way to get the stuff through, and it will definitely arrive on their side. Or most likely it's the most reliable thing by a, yeah, by a long shot. And yeah, when you get an invite by somebody else, the game invites will actually land down here. The problem with these is they don't give you much information on what you are joining. It only says who is inviting you, and that's about it. You don't know if it's a race job, you don't know if it's like a heist finale or something like that. So that's what I don't like about these, and that's the only reason why I would maybe slightly avoid them. But if you definitely want a certain other person in, definitely go through these in order to get them here. Apart from that, you can also take a look at different crews here, which again, through the website, will likely be a bit easier. You can also view crew invites that you sent or that you yeah, got from other people. Look at your crew members here. Manage your crews. Find certain players to send them a friend request or something like that. Also view a friend request and also see the friends that you have currently. You can remove them from your friends list or send them a message or just block them altogether if you so desire. But yeah, that's the most important stuff here. Besides that, there are also some settings like viewing your personal messages here or just taking a look at certain visibility stuff like hiding notifications or so, having some privacy stuff. Viewing your linked accounts and all that. I think that's still all better on the website. The only thing that I really use here is game settings and presence visibility. You can actually set it so that nobody sees that you're online. And if I'm just, I don't know, AFK grinding something or just doing my own thing in general, this is a pretty good thing to just set it to, yeah, for your visibility to only be limited to yourself. So other people don't bother sending you invites all the time. Sadly, if you set this to yourself only and when you want to set it to something else, you will need to restart your game in order for that to take effect. It sadly doesn't automatically update. You will actually need to go out of the game and completely reboot it. But yeah, so much about that. Let's get into the phone. The phone is mostly for invites and stuff, but it also has a few nice little things for just yeah, for just the session you are in. Gonna quickly go through the most important contacts here. You can, by the way, not only go up and down the list, but also press left in order to skip up by 5, or right to skip down by 5 in order to navigate the entire thing a bit quicker. So the important guys that you want to know. At certain points, when you get like a tank or something, or just a regular old helicopter, jet ski, whatever, you will need to go through Pegasus and order stuff for their account
Hello, this is
in order to have
Pegasus
it
Lifestyle
spawned on the map.
Management. How can I help?
So here I could just go and order a plane or something.
Call again. Goodbye.
So that's one thing that you may need to know. Apart from that, Morse Mutual is important because that's the vehicle insurance company. If one of your cars gets blown up or destroyed other ways, like being put into the sea or something, you just call them and you get a replacement. It doesn't happen automatically, sadly. So if you have your car destroyed, it was insured, you wonder where it went, definitely call them in order to get a replacement. The mechanic is a contact you unlock once you get to own any garage or apartment or so. With him, you can just order any vehicles to spawn nearby. So, unless you are already nearby a current vehicle, you can just spawn in a new one. So, that's usually quite useful and one of the most used contacts, besides maybe Lester. Lester is one of the most versatile guys in the game. There are a few other contacts that can do
What's up,
stuff for you.
pal?
But he is one of the really important ones. I think you get them by either at the start of the game, after you gain some levels, you should get an invite to go to a certain point on the map to meet him, or at the latest, it's at some point when you get your first luxury apartment. I don't exactly know when you unlock Lester. But yeah, with him, you can set bounties on other player to yeah, initiate a bounty hunt if somebody pisses you off. Not all that important, but removing wanted level, usually costing $200 per level, It's pretty important to just get rid of cops real quick. Sometimes it doesn't really work all that well, though. I did it a few times where it just refreshes right after I got rid of a corpse. And if it's scripted, you won't be able to use this at all, but yeah, just if you ran into a police car or something, if you mowed over a few too many pedestrians, getting rid of a corpse real easy is quite a nice thing. Off the radar removes you from the radar for other players, so you won't be visible there for quite a while. I think it's like 2 minutes, 5 minutes, something like that. Allows you to do something that you need to do without being bothered, usually. Unless somebody finds you on the street and you are yeah, behaving a bit out of line. Besides that, the heist options and all that are not all that important. But cops turning a blind eye for I think 5 minutes is also quite nice, because then you can just go on a rampage and do whatever you want to without being bothered by cops, and it's quite nice. I don't think it gets rid of any cops that you have right now, but yeah, if you don't have any cops and want to keep it for a while, this is how to do that.
Give me a call back when simple decisions don't freak you out so much.
So Lester, ultimately one of the most important guys in here. Besides that, there's also Lamar, for example, who can send a mug on other people, so if they have a bit of cash lying around here, that NPC will just get them and grab the stuff and try to make a run for it until somebody kills them. And things like that, most other stuff is more for late game or if you buy certain properties and all that stuff. But these are definitely the most usable ones. Text is for all your text messages land, by the way. What I should also mention, you get the phone up by pressing the D-pad up. I don't know which button it is on the keyboard, but you can look that up in the pause menu. Emails, usually some offers or maybe some treasure hunts. Treasure hunts in particular are usually pretty good to go for. They give some really decent rewards and all that. And for joining other people's shops, you have these two options. Job list usually means that somebody invited you to something and you will just be able to join them. However, only join the stuff that doesn't have a real profile pic. If you have somebody like Gerald here or Martin, these are NPCs and they are just offering you empty jobs, so you could go in there and host it yourself. If you just want to host, if you just want to join somebody, wait for yeah, for an invite from somebody else. And if you just want to look for a specific job, go to yeah, play Quick Job. And then you can choose between a lot of different options right here and just join whatever you want in order to yeah, find a lobby that is in the same targeting mode and already has somebody hosting, so you will just be able to join that. And the game will actually keep you in your own session until the host of that session launches it. Then you get pulled in there until then you can still do in free roam whatever you want. Also, if you land into something that you don't want to do, I'm gonna quickly demonstrate that. For example, let's say I want to do an open wheel race. I'm looking for a job now. And now I'm in a job that I don't want to do. I just go in here, go to play Quick Job again. I am in the list here and I just back out again and I'm out of that again. So that's how that works. That's how you can just quickly find a different kind of job there. So yeah, so much about this one. You can also hide a few options in the hide options menu, which I will show in a moment. This one here is for VIP or CEO invites, which can only for the most part happen in public sessions, or you will need other people for in here for this to be important. Also, sometimes if you are doing a VIP mission or so, this button might be something else that is not this menu again, but yeah, something required for the mission itself, so keep an eye out on that. Besides that, let's quickly go into the internet, and there are really only two things that you need to know about: money and services, and travel and transport. Money and services allows you to buy different properties. For example, you can buy regular properties right here on the Dynasty 8 website. Some things for for different businesses would be on the Maze Bank Foreclosures website. And down here is the most commonly used one. I'm sad that they didn't put it at the top, because this is where you can actually deposit some of your money. I right now have almost 180,000 and I can just put that into my bank account so nobody can steal it. I think stealing is limited to like what, 20, 25, 50k, something like that. But yeah, if you don't want to have big chunks of your money stolen, for some reason your phone can just destroy that money and put it on your bank account, or you can also put stuff out of a bank account and into your wallet. But yeah, that's all that is there to money and services, and you can find different vehicles to buy on these websites. Not gonna go through all of them. Arena War is for the most part for overpriced vehicles that you don't really use outside of a really pay to win late game mode, which a lot of people don't even find all that fun. I personally enjoy it, but I would stay away from that until you have like millions to spare. Benny's is for highly customizable vehicles, but also like what's this called? Also like Arena War, you can have some of the stock vehicles in here. So if you want something specific, like the current Sultan or something, you can just buy that on here. Legendary Motorsport and Southern San Andreas Super Autos is for regular vehicles. A lot of newer ones are in there as well. Yeah, this one is for planes. This one is for militarized vehicles, for boats and for bicycles. For some reason, I don't know why that has its own website. But that's about it. I don't think there's anything else that's really important for the internet here. So next up, the interaction menu. You bring that up by, I think it's pressing M on the keyboard. Yep. Or by holding the back button for a few seconds. So yeah, this is the interaction menu, and it's really important. You can check your daily objective if you want to do them. I think that gives like 25k after you finish all three of them. Can be a bit of a pain, but can also be quite interesting, or at least profitable. Inventory is where you can check your body armor, which you can buy at ammunition. So you can stack up on some body armor and just equip it during the missions or something. So that's quite useful. Snacks is another important one, which I already mentioned, and you can check on your snacks right here. Also eat them if you want to, which will look a bit like this. And yeah, not too much to talk about here, but definitely keep them filled up and they will replenish your health while eating them. Not all of them though. The Pisswasser is beer, and it will just make you get drunk. Smokes, I don't know if they do anything either. You can actually buy ammo through this menu as well. So this is quite cool if you need to stack up on ammo. This able custom weapon loader, which only becomes more important later when you can have a weapon locker to hide some weapons that you don't really use. And some other stuff here, which is really only for later game things that don't matter at the beginning. You can change some of your style and even your character look right here. You can set different outfits for racing. You can set a default helmet or something like that, and change your regular outfit that you are wearing in GTA Online. You can set these up in any clothing shop or in your apartment. Okay, that was a testing one. So stuff like that. Quite interesting, I think. And you can also go into accessories and just change up some mess or whatever you are wearing. Vehicles is quite important, because if your vehicle is somewhere on the map or it got destroyed and being put together by Morse Mutual and it is somewhere active on the map, you can just call it to yourself. You can also call in different other vehicles from the hangar, which you may buy at some point. Request a special vehicle from the vehicle warehouse. Or return your personal vehicle to the storage. This is a nice thing if you want to call another vehicle, but your current one It's right next to you, just call it to the storage, and when you can just ask a mechanic to give you another one. You can empty your vehicle if somebody's in there that you don't want in there, and you can also restrict vehicle access, so if you don't want others to get into your vehicle, just say to no one. Or you could also say that nobody else besides me is allowed to drive it, so everybody else would just be passenger. And stuff like that. You can also remotely open doors. And things like that. The rest doesn't really matter all that much. Services is for later. If you buy any of these things, you can just spawn them into a world in order to interact with them or get some other kind of service in here. I think that's best to be explored once you get any of these things. Secure stuff is also interesting for people that start out. Once you get 50k in your menu or in your wallet, you can actually go into this menu and register as a VIP instead of a CEO. And then you can get into different kinds of missions right here. The VIP work, there is some stuff in there that's actually quite lucrative, but I will rather mention that in another video, which will be more about the money making side. But yeah, that stuff is definitely important. Hide options, they allow you to remove stuff from the map. So you can get rid of all the jobs, so you can have all of them active. Which on the map suddenly makes it look like this. Gonna quickly go into the options again and remove that. And suddenly it looks again like this because I only have a certain set of things open. Besides that, you can also get rid of certain events if you don't want to do some of the stuff in free roam. Other than that, there's also the option to remove some stores and all that. The important things in here that I would get rid of would be, where is it, dispatch services and simum repo missions. Because otherwise you will have some certain markers on the map. For example, the simum repo missions would be the S down here. And every time you go somewhere, anywhere nearby a block or something, even if you are on the highway, the guy will just send you a message with like, hey, you owe me a favor or something. If you however set that to hidden, then that stuff will not show up for you. So that's a pretty good option to have. So yeah, that's so much about that. Apart from that, spawn location is pretty interesting. You could just always set that to a certain, what's this called, certain apartment or a hangar, a warehouse or a bunker, whatever. And yeah, that's depending on where you spawn into, or where you want to spawn into a session. Once you join the session, that's where you land up. If you get killed, you will not be using that to get into another location. It's only if you join a session the first time, then that's where you will get into. There's an option to kill yourself if you want to, doesn't really do all that much, and passive mode enable. And I think that's about it for everything. God, that took a while longer than I wanted it to, but I thought I had to explain quite a few things, and there are also a lot of things to just, things that you may want to know in order to get the most out of it. So yeah, I hope this was at least useful. And see you next time when I give you some tips on what to buy the first time around or something like that. So we'll get to that in the next video. Thanks for watching, and yeah, I hope you got some use out of it. And till then, bye bye.